ancient time, trade flourished in the Mediterranean and Red Seas, and scholars recognized the advantage to be gained by connecting the two bodies. As early as 1500 BC, scholars of Egypt's New Kingdom commissioned the building of a canal between the Nile and the Red Sea. This early canal was covered by sand. And though the late 7th century BC pharaoh Nepho II attempted to build a new canal, the project would not be completed until the Persian invasion of Darius after 522 BC. This canal eventually met the same fate as its predecessors, as successive rulers, the Greeks under Ptolemy I and Cleopatra, and later the Romans under Trajan, attempted to restore it, but in each case, the canal fell into disrepair. Finally, de Lesseps, the former French consul to Egypt, received a 99-year concession on the canal from the Khedive of Egypt. With a crew of some 2.4 million Egyptian workers, he commenced the building project, which cost more than 125,000 lives over the course of a decade. Not a single Egyptian living today can say his ancestors' lives were not touched by the project in some way. After a decade of hard work and great sacrifice, the canal opened with much ceremony on November 17, 1869. The celebration was a lavish affair, organized by Khedive Ismaili, and attended by many dignitaries and notables of the time, amongst them Empress Eugenie of France. President Gamal Abdel Nasser nationalized the Suez Canal on the 26th of July, 1956. Though Britain, France and Israel united together against Egypt and Nasser's attempts. But the Egyptian nation stood together against their aggression, and the canal remained in Egyptian hands. On the 8th of June 1967, Israel occupied the canal and closed it down to use for the whole world for 8 long years. Egypt lost massive revenues from the closure of the canal, averaging at around $1,700 million annually. In order to return Egyptian territory to its rightful owners, late President Anwar Sadat took the brave decision to declare war on Israel in 1973. Egypt was victorious and recovered its territory. The canal was officially reopened on the 5th of June 1975, linking mankind to one another and continuing its service to the global trade and economy.